Dan and I had a dream to build a home for our family, and that's what we were in the process of doing when the accident occurred on August the 20th.
Project Dan is a community effort to give back and honor Dan Stuart for his dedication and selfless giving. Dan was a headstrong man of great character. He was dedicated to his family and our community.
All right, Dan and I were friends for, you know, for the past 7-8 years. I first met him with a phone call, telling my little girl, his little girl was on my softball team, and I was going to coach her first year she'd ever played. You know, when he showed up for our first practice. Dan didn't know anything about softball. He'd never played the game. He'd never been out there at Sunrise, where we all started at. As the years progressed, he learned more. He started coaching with me. Started spending tons of time out there at the softball fields. Did tons of things for the girls. He started coaching. I learned the game real well. All the girls loved him. He got on the board out at Sunrise. He spent countless hours out there on the board doing things for the organization. All about the kids with Dan. We were friends for a good long while. All the little girls gave Dan the Mr. Dan name. Had nothing to do with me. It's all the little girls that he coached. They were around him all the time. It's all you heard all the time. Mr. Dan. My little girl, Avery, she's one of the ones that started it, I'm sure. She loved him like possibly a father. You know, Dan used to come by my shop in the mornings to talk about softball. And it's just countless hours that he put in with the girls, talking about softball, doing things. It's all about the girls to him. So.
Along with softball, he was an active member of Macedonia Baptist Church and enjoyed serving others. One of Dan's biggest desires was to provide a more suitable home for his family. Their home is damaged beyond repair. He was in the process of making some home improvements when the unthinkable happened.
Well, like, at nights, my dad would come and, you know, lay on the bed with me, and we'd talk about, like, special things. And he would always, we would share secrets and stuff like that. But when we go in the ball field, it's like a total different ball game. I mean, he's, you know, like the man out there. He does everything out there. If you go around and look, you're like, who did this? It's my dad. He spent a lot of time out there. He'd even, you know, he was willing to lose time with us, really, to go out there and help with all those little girls that, that love softball so much. And, he's just a really kind guy. His legacy is, you know, awesome. And, all I want y'all to know is that he might be, you know, crazy and, you know, but in really deep inside, he's a really, you know, he's fat, but he's really sweet and lovable and stuff like that.
My dad's legacy, we are his legacy. Like, the whole softball field is his legacy. Like Sunrise Community Center, that's his legacy. He lived through softball. Like, that's what his life revolved around for, like, the past 4 years. I was the little girl that, I was the one that got him into it. Like, I played for Mr. Dickey, the guy that y'all heard from earlier. I'm the one who got his heart into it because I was so excited to go play softball, and he took it and ran with it. He did things that most people never would have. He took his time out and went and did it, as she said earlier. One thing I would like everybody to remember about my dad, I guess, would be that he was charismatic and not the big bully that some people think that he is, and that he cared more about others than he cared about himself, and he was very selfless.
Well, the thing that, you know, people might remember him by, or I would like people to remember him by, is he looks like a huge, huge, meanie head. But at times, whenever we would, like, whenever we were bad, you know, like, all the time, he wasn't, like, mean, but he just wanted us to learn from our mistakes. And... he was just the best. You know, he was my friend. He was the best. And
in October of 2011, Dan and his wife Liz were on their way to watch their oldest daughter play softball. when they were involved in a fatal accident that took his life. It's been a year now since the devastating tragedy, and close friends of Dan and Liz envision a community teaming up and working together to carry on Dan's dream of building his wife and three daughters a new home.
Dan and I met in April of 2008 on the softball field. It was Jordan's first year to play, and we had a rain delay, and we kind of just started talking, and you know, it went from there. Dan was an amazing man. He really was an unselfish man. The girls have all said that he was, you know, he was this big old bear looking man, but really and truly, y'all, he had a heart as big as gold. I mean, he would do anything for anybody and put everybody else ahead of him. Dan and I had a wonderful and amazing relationship, and I am very sad that God took him away from us, but that was God's plan. Dan and I had a dream of building a house that was suitable for our four children. It never happened. I don't know, you know, what the plan holds, but we just know it's God's plan, and we are very thankful that we had him for the time we had him, and the 4 years that I had Dan was just the best 4 years of my life.
I met Dan right around the time him and Liz got together. First time I really ever spent time with Dan was in a car ride when they were waiting on me so we could go to Joe and Christy's wedding. Spent a good while in the car talking to him, kind of afraid of him. Once you get to know him, he's a big teddy bear. I was pretty much Liz's adopted daughter at the point in time. Dan took me under his wing as the adopted daughter of his family. I became a sister to his kids. I babysat. I was a part of the family. They're a big part of my life, and this house was their dream to put a suitable roof over their kids, to raise them to be what God wanted them to be. His kids, softball, his family was his life. He dedicated time to the high school slow pitch team. He dedicated time to softball. That was his life. He is one of the most caring men I've ever met. He was a very big part of my life, a very father figure to me.
Liz and the girls are packed up and moving into their parents' home for the next several months. Demolition of their home is planned for Saturday, November the 10th. Over the next several weeks, plans for the foundation and plumbing of Project Dan will take place. Any ideas for fundraising and donations are greatly appreciated. We welcome any organization, church, or business as volunteers, sponsors, and most importantly, prayer warriors. Find out more information by visiting Project Dan on Facebook or follow us on Twitter.
My family needs your help with donations and time given to help build this house for them. This is Dan's dream, was to give a house to his girls. And there's nothing more than that. That's what he wants. And we just ask that donations, time spent towards Project Dan from everybody.